A class is a template used to create objects. They are made up of members, the main two of which are fields and methods. Fields are variables that hold the state of the object, while the methods define what the object can do. The class can also have a constructor. This is a special kind of method used to initialize the object. It always has the same name as the class, and it doesn't have a return type, since it implicitly returns a new instance of the class. To be accessible from another class, it needs to be declared with a public access modifier. When we create a new instance of this class, the constructor method is called, which here sets the fields to some default values. If we want to, we can add a parameter list to the constructor to make the field's initial values depend on the parameters passed when creating the object. Inside of the constructor, as well as in other methods belonging to the object, we can use a special keyword called this, which is a reference to the current instance of the class. If we, for example, use the same name for the parameters as for the fields, we could still access the fields by using the this keyword, even though they are overshadowed by the local variables. To support different parameter lists, we can overload the constructor. If the class is now instantiated without any parameters, the fields will be assigned default values. With one parameter, both fields will be set to that value, and for two parameters, each of them will be assigned to a field. Trying to create the object with more parameters than we have defined, or with incorrect data types, will result in an error, just as with any other method. The this keyword can also be used to call one constructor from another. That way, we don't have to duplicate as much code. Note that the keyword appears as a function call, and that it must be on the first line in the constructor. If there are fields in the class that needs to be initialized to default values, such as in the first constructor here, we can just as well initialize the fields at the same time as they are declared. These default values will be assigned just before the constructor is called. It's possible to create a class even if there are no constructors defined. This is because the compiler will then automatically create a default constructor which takes no parameters when the program compiles.